Tech companies have been easing us into gadgets and services that make use of virtual eyes and ears for a while now. Things that might have made us uncomfortable even a few years ago are part of everyday life. Alexa listens for our request to turn on the lights and the music, ring and Nest watch us and every stranger that comes near our door. In places like San Francisco, being followed around by cameras in a cashierless store isn't really creepy anymore. It's just what you do when you're hungry, like I am right now. I think about privacy more than the average person, and I still regularly grab snacks at my local Amazon Go store. Here in Las Vegas at CES, the year's biggest tech show, we got a peek at where this technology is headed in the not-so-distant future. Companies are showcasing tech that combines cameras, sensors, and artificial intelligence in ways they say will make our lives easier and safer, in exchange for ever more monitoring. Often you won't even know the technology is there. Like in the case of the hotel I'm in right now, it's hiding out in these planters. Which raises some interesting questions about, you know, consent. Meet Patscan, a technology that uses microwave radar, chemical sensing, and object detection to spot guns, knives, and even drugs in a bag or on a person, say, in the parking lot of a school. Its AI cameras can be paired with a smart locking system that can automatically secure a building if there's a weapon detected outside. And it could all happen covertly while you're going to see a show or picking your kids up from school or rooting for your favorite baseball team. The system is already set to be installed at the home field of the Cincinnati Reds. Patscan doesn't have facial recognition built in, but it can be added if a client specifically asks for it. Clients can also decide whether or not to let people know they're being scanned. The company says it doesn't collect or store data associated with specific individuals. Another similar technology platform is Eyeris, which combines various sensors to figure out what's going on in a car. Cameras can detect objects, eye movements, and even some emotional facial expressions. Radar can confirm the presence of a person, plus track your heart rate and respiration. Thermal sensors pick up body and surface temperatures. How might this be useful? Well, for one thing, object detection may mean one day getting an alert from your driverless cab that you're about to leave your bag behind. For drivers, body analytics can be used for the perfect steering wheel adjustment. Size-appropriate airbags can be deployed. If a child is screaming in the back seat, calming music might be queued up. Are you eating or texting or not keeping your eyes on the road enough? What's your threshold for road rage? The system is designed to figure out if you're stressed. It can also take cues from your facial expressions and body language to guess when your mind is wandering. The same data collection that enables autopilot features that could be a godsend one day could turn into a nightmare the next. How much do we want our cars to really know about us? Could that information land in the hands of insurance companies or an attorney arguing a lawsuit against us over an accident? The answer to all of this is absolutely yes. The company says the benefits far outweigh any privacy concerns. It fully expects this data to be used to help shed light on what happened before an accident and for drivers to share it with their insurance companies. The earliest Eyeris will be on the road is in Karma's Rivero in 2021. These are fresh capabilities that could very well be life-changing, even life-saving. One day, we may welcome all these benefits, but in the meantime, we'll continue to think about the trade-offs.